Gentlemen, we are Gunsmoke, and it's great to be back with you here again this year for Music Mountain. We've been looking forward to it all summer long, so we hope you enjoy the show.
Yeah.
so much, ladies and gentlemen. For tonight's show, we thought we'd take you to Nashville, and we're going to spend the first hour of our show at the world-famous Grand Ole Opry. And the Opry began broadcasting live on Saturday nights in 1925 on WSM Radio. It was the longest-running radio program in the world. And starting in the 1980s, they began to televise it. There's, to this day, there's still a portion of the show that's televised. And when an artist gets asked to join the Opry, they become called a star of the Grand Ole Opry. And for over 50 years, Roy Acuff started the Opry each Saturday night with his signature song, Wabash Cannonball. Insurance company sponsored one of the biggest stars the Grand Ole Opry ever had. And when he performed, the lines would stretch out Broadway and down Fifth Avenue. He died in 1951 at the age of 29 years old, and his songs are still recorded today. They've been recorded from Dean Martin to Martina McBride, and that's Hank Williams.
I tried so hard, my dear, to show you're my little dream. If you're afraid, each thing I do just some evil scheme. All memory from your own so past keeps us so far apart. Why can't I free your doubtful mind? love you.
On the Opry short being after Hank Williams died in 1951, and he's had a string of hits. He's 87 years old, and he brought the house down this past March in his latest appearance at the Grand Ole Opry. Here's a couple of Ray Price big hits. One more time.
Gunsmoke backup singers here, the crew that we were going out for. It was very good.
Immediately following the broadcast, they started a tradition back in the 1940s, a great Ernest Tubb, who has a chain of chain of record stores down there, started something called the Midnight Jamboree, which is also broadcast live on WSM Radio. And it's the second longest running radio program in the world. And we've appeared on that show twice, and we're looking forward to going back. So right after the Grand Ole Opry, some of the stars from the Grand Ole Opry go and appear at the Midnight Jamboree at the Ernest Tubb Record Shop on Music Valley Drive. We're gonna do a couple of Ernest Tubb's big hits. In the 1960s, the Opry saw an influx of new stars led led by the legendary Patsy Cline.
Oh, why do I let it die?
next song debuted on the Opry right around the same time as Patsy Cline debuted there. And it was written by Billy Grammer. Billy Grammer invented a type of guitar. It's a very rare guitar today. And he passed away this past year, so we're going to dedicate this song to him.
You have to go. You can't
became famous for his, not only for his songs, but also because instead of the cowboy outfits and the rhinestone outfits that the stars of the Grand Ole Opry wore, he wore sweaters all the time. He's still on the Opry today, and that's Charlie Pride.
Our nation, I am all against them. Feeling is out.
Oh,
travel in Houston, rode my lady in Santa Fe. Lost my wife and a girlfriend somewhere along the way. Got me looking for England, they pull that game. Got me hoping they could change
some products.